Right, where were we? We're about to hunt down what's terrorizing these disappearing villages. Get after them. Direwolves, 8 of them. Shit, that's kind of scary. Yeah, I definitely want... Yeah, we're not going to have a chance to take a shot at anything here. At least the flanks are secure if need. Then Huskals are there as well. Kind of wonder if this if I could do better this long axe. In fact, let's do this. Cause he's only got 59 accuracy, he's very unlikely to hit with the long axe. Let's switch it out to a pitchfork. More likely to hit. Less damage, but it's more reliable. Just really hope we get to get this shield wall down. Nope. No such luck. Spear wall, I mean. Direwolves are actually pretty damn scary. So some of them are frenzied direwolves. I think the frenzied direwolves have overwhelmed, so we'll be focusing this one down. Sweet, it's panicking. God.
Your mother was a hamster, and your father smelt of elderberries.
Peace zone. Thanks for the follow, friend. Your mother was a hamster, your father smelt of elderberries. Yeah, they're definitely going to hit the flanks, especially here, so Hardwig needs to get the shield and the spear out. This is also why you put swords on them, so they can go into riposte. Raggle, do you have quick hands? You do. But you, Loki, you don't have quick hands. Stick with the spear then. Super, no quick hands either. Oh, good, stabbed in the guts. That is probably a little too bold, moving forward like that. But if I move forward, I think he should shield wall. If he can get through the turn without too much damage, I expect him to be surrounded. Then he can whip out the warbrand and swing it in a nice big arc. Plan at least. Randolph, no quick hands. Stabby stab. Yes, the fact that we've managed to break two of them is amazing. And damn near kill a third. Oh, so close. Direwolves are no joke. Ah, that's why I love riposte. That's exactly why I hoard the swords. Ah. The deluxe edition, it's more of a supporters edition. You get this little helmet called the Fangshire, which allows the person wearing it to shoot at night without any night penalties. And I think there's a digital art book and original soundtrack. But I bought the supporters edition mostly because I just love the game so much. I want to support it. Yes, this is the one nice thing about these little wolfies is that their morale breaks pretty easy. This went very well. I'm pleased with how this went, but these three are still super dangerous. These two are still super dangerous. Oh, you have to love riposte. Out of, oh damn, we're out of ammo. Shit. In that case, save the ammo. Ulrich's carrying all of it. Anyway, one of the cities we work for must have a Fletcher that can give us arrows for cheap. Sweet. We took a lot less damage than I was expecting. Pleased with that. That's what I did. I started off with the basic edition and then I bought the supporters edition a little bit later. And then when it's payday, I'm actually going to buy a copy of this for a friend. Great work, chaps. Well fought. 8 sets of wolf armor. You won't be sorry, man. This game's amazing. Any level ups? Just the one. On Ulrich. Awesome. He can be a bowmaster now. I obviously want to get 2 bowmasters just as soon as I can. Are we seriously out of mission? P8, not enough, 65. Tell you what. If I can get you to 70 fatigue, I think I can justify keeping the arming sword on you. Yeah. Like so. Worth every penny. Hashtag true facts. Absolutely worth the money. Mean rag. Out. So 59 AM, you're not gonna hit anything, are you? Ah, it's fine. Hang on to that bludgeon. That's also fine. Not much of an archer. You're not much of anything, Juno. Good thing is we're in a financial position now where we can start spending a thousand and a half even to recruit new guys. I will definitely do so. Oh, hell yes. We can just sell all the wolf pelts because we don't need... well, we're not going to be hiring a tailor, so we can't actually build the wolf armor. Yeah, welcome to the struggle, mate. You want to see, watch the evolution of a player and like watching them learn what not to do, then watch my YouTube videos. God, I look back on those first few campaigns and it's just so cringe, really. So bad. Okay, good. We've got loads of food. Got a decent amount of ammo. That's a bit more than I wanted to pay for it, but we should be able to turn a good profit now. Oh, geez. Whoopsie. Oh, obviously the second I go out, it's payday. Damn, that's gonna hurt everybody's morale. Silly, silly, silly. Okay, so only half the guys didn't get paid. Okay, so I wonder how it works it out, like randomly. Lovely bit of profit there. 4 days worth. This all spoils in 6 days, 13 days. We can keep buying food if it's cheap and it's nice food. I'm trying to keep it varied. I want the morale buff from all the varied food. Got a booze for you guys. Goat's cheese. Lovely cured venison. Okay, that's enough now. Ooh. Okay, so financially, what's our next objective? I think I want to hire guys to replace the shitters that we have, frankly. You know, one shot. Hunter, no. Well, the bloody, he's expensive. Can't afford him. Engineer is not one of the classes we're going to be hiring. I could hire another poacher, but we don't need another backline archer. We've already got one poacher. Got the two archers we need. We'll just keep working. Brigands, what you're talking about? 190, so it must be quite close. Yeah, go on. No one's hurt. Take a look at what we've got here. 2,800, that's nice and cheap. Eventually, I want all of the front line to be using reinforced male hauberks. The male hauberks don't have good enough armor to fatigue ratio. I mean, the scale armor has one of the best, but it's super expensive. Yeah, I should also think about buying heater shields as well. That's probably a good buy now for 360. He's our most valuable person up front. 68. It's probably Fraggle Jim. And he's got the fatigue for it. Okay. No, we're not going very far. Name a sergeant to rally on the battlefield. Yes. I think I've got that already. In fact, I'm pretty sure I do. So I think the cities where we're most likely to find the type of guys that I want to hire are these built-up cities and the military ones. You got for us? Disowned noble. He's on the menu, but too expensive. Historian? Nope. Oh, I like the sound of this lad. Berserker. Can't afford him, though. Eric the chicken? Nope. So there's no one here that I want to hire. You crappy peddlers. The disowned noble and the sellsword are tempting, but we can't afford them. Let's see what Volenstadt has for us. Well, Fraggle. What can I say? Maybe blocking the enemy's blows with your head isn't the right option. Skillfully block the blow with his face. Yeah, it's always so disappointing when you lose a very, very strong soldier. No, none of these are guys that fit the class descriptions of what you want to hire. But this is probably a good time to buy at least one war dog. We can even think about... oh, hang on, there's the sash already. Random. Which of the two sergeants has the lower resolve? This one, so we give him the sash. That actually worries me a bit, because the sash just appeared in the inventory and we didn't get the little bit of text. Okay, fair enough. Whatever. Keep working, we need more money. And once we can afford a falcon, we can go do some raiding as well. But I don't want to start raiding places until I've got a solid lineup of 12 guys who I'm happy with. Still need to replace our two cripples. And our one refugee. I'll even hire deserters. The deserters have been surprisingly good. They're really cheap. And getting over their very low morale is actually pretty easy. Relic I need finding. Forefather standard. Let's talk money. 630. I accept. Worn down fortress. I accept. Is everybody in decent shape? I think so. We've got no injuries. We've got no armor damage. Just make sure everyone has the correct weapons. This could be bandits, so let's be prepared for that eventuality. Right. Go to the flail. If you fighting against someone with a shield, you use that. No shield, you use that. I think same story. Yep, nice big swords. Thanks. Okay. Like having a little think here. Correct. Fine. Love to have a couple more of these flails though, that are so good. Had a star dog. Worn down fortress, northeast. Oh god, we're gonna be fighting in a swamp. Ugh. That's awesome. One of my late game archers like that as well with a warbow. But just what you got to remember with taking berserk, you better have the fatigue for it, because then you're shooting three times in a turn and you run out of fatigue so damn quick. Ooh, many. Oh, that I definitely want to fight that as soon as they come out of the swamp. Well, let's go fight that worn down fortress and then go chase those undead. We'll see what. Actually, you know what? No, I don't want to. This is too good an opportunity to miss. We can always come back to that once we've healed up. Just follow the zombies out of the swamp. Nice. Hopefully we can get some armor out of this, but this does mean I need to switch to zombie killing weapons. A few Noctares as well. Fine. Flail's actually totally fine. I'm pretty sure that if you use a flail and you kill them with lash, it explodes the head and counts as a fatality so they can't rise up. Butcher cleaver, cleaver, flail, noise! Then the lads, the Huskarls, can actually have swords and shields if they need them. Excellent. Get a little bit further away from the. Oh, for goodness sake! Come back here! Ugh! Yeah, it's dusk, it's almost dark. I believe that all blunt weapons can crush their head. In the same way that a sword can decapitate, but it's a percentage chance. So I think if you use lash, it's 100% chance. Kill them with it. And if you use a cleaver, it's obviously to decapitate. It's 100% chance to decapitate. If we move forward, I think we do. If I can take this bit of high ground, I'll be very happy with it. Or is it better to get the few extra... You know, let's retreat to this bit of high ground. And that'll give us a few extra turns as well. Shoot at these bastards. Nice little dick shaped bit of high ground. Quickly, men, retreat to the penis! Landarian, secure the balls! Jerno, get on the shaft! Should definitely mark this stream for mature audiences. Ironic, because none of us are mature at all. God, this whiskey's nice. Battle of Penis Hill. Famed by historians. Wow, what a long and hard battle it was. I'm such a child. I can't believe I'm 34 years old laughing at dick jokes. Oh well. So the nice little setup though for fighting, I've got to say. Also, the sound of the zombies quite amuses me quite a lot. Sound kind of like old men, just my back hurts. Looks like they're gonna hit us more from the north. That was a long shot, literally. I prioritize killing the ones with spears. They're way more dangerous because they're more likely to hit, of course. Fine shot. Last thing is we've got probably two or three turns before they even hit the front lines. Keep taking pot shots. Oh, but I shouldn't be killing them, that's stupid. That one, he's just going to rise up again. I should get them wounded and within one shot of dying. Let them get a bit closer and make the shots easier. And later on in the game, when you start fighting whole groups of armored Vadagangas and ghosts, geests, oh, nightmare. On my offline campaign, I fought a group of 26. It was 22 armored Vadagangas and 6 ghosts. Ugh, in a swamp. Is that 65? Oh, come on, dude. Yeah, that's the wrong episode number. Also, I shouldn't be killing them that far out, because then these bloody Noctares are going to eat the corpses. Nasty little fuckers that they are. One more shot in this one. Ah! Good shooting. I'd love to get that armor, but let's not mess around with these things. There's 9 of them after all. And as soon as these Noctares are in range of the archers, we've got to start shooting at them. Shoot this one, or you know what, fuck it, just take it down. Don't even mess around. We'll decapitate wherever possible. We're not going to leave them alive. Try to use the decapitate ability. Okay, archers, here are your targets, those little gray fuckers. Spread out your shots. Oh no, that's fine. Keep hitting that one. Because then as that one dies, the others will go to that spot as well to try to eat its corpse. Disgusting. Terrible shot. Oh, I love using spear wall. When it works, it's bloody great. Ooh, good shooting. I 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, this is all 10 of them. Ah, oh, good shooting, Ulrich. You know what? Let's move forward for the decapitations. Can't move forward, doesn't come to you. If they can get forward, doesn't look like they can. Oh, good work, Hartwig. Spear wall's working too well, lads. Let's get the cleavers out. Archie? Randolph. Oh, we're tired, are we? This hits. Aha! Beautiful! One more. Oh, that armor, damn it. So that was Lesh. So if this one rises up, that'll answer our question as to whether or not it counts as a decapitation. It's great fun, decapitating zombies. Okay, good, so that was the flail guy who's risen up again now. That answers that. That's very satisfying, just moving forward and cutting heads off. Get off to that Nocta before it escapes. Love to get my hands on that coif that he's wearing. Hold your fire. I don't see the point. Oh good, he'll just bleed to death, I reckon. Yeah, he'll just drop on the next turn. Save our ammo here. Yeah. Ammo costs money, of course. Down to our last few arrows. Awesome, we can just let this thing drop, but in any case, just be sure. I'm so glad I've kept all these different weapons. It's really, really cool using the weapons situationally for when they're the most, you know, like this. Not much in the way of money, but this is all about getting a bit extra bit of XP. We didn't get a level up, but no, better than nothing. Let's go back to our normal setup though. Arming sword. Correct. That's what I want you to have. I want you to have that before, so you need a flail. Gate. Flail is fine. Two. Ugh, that's not good. You just gotta stick with your spear. Yeah. Everybody up front got daggers? Yes, well, the four in front did. What are you doing? Okay, just one hit point of damage, and that should be repaired before we attack. Yeah. I think we'll attack in the morning, because we're going to be fighting in a swamp, so I'm going to want to have the archers. two, three, four. Everybody filled their quivers. Time. We're fully healed, fully repaired. Get to it. Wonder what this is going to be. I hope it's not raiders. Okay. Congregation of a door will eat up sunlight and earn their salary and a relic in hands. Ghost. Bombs. Oh, damn it. Okay, luckily we've got a bunch of flails up front, because fighting these things, they all have shields. And thank goodness we aren't in the horrible swamp. We're on pretty neutral ground. This is going to be tough, though. The thing is, the bows and arrows don't do a damn thing. But I'm glad that we have this two-handed axe. I don't see us using the Warbrand, honestly. I'm gonna go straight to flails on everyone, if at all possible. Well, flails and Morningstar? No. Doesn't have plus to hit, so he's gonna struggle to get past the shield. Boar Spear would at least have plus 20, more likely to hit. I mean, they have so little hit points. Spears are actually fine if you don't have flails. It's fine. And it's not worth using spear wall against these guys, because they just put their shields up and walk into it. Or rather just use shield wall. Just try to outlast them. I hope we've got more than just two flails. Oh, these ball bags are going to be tough, the legionaries. Ugh. Not all that we can do. Because even moving forward costs fatigue. That's not worth doing. I feel like for the first few turns, the whole front line should keep their shield wall up. And we're going to get flanked and outnumbered quite badly here. We're at 41, 40. I think just smash one of the shields. And the problem is they're all shield experts, so it takes two shots to smash a shield. 19%, 24%. Just gotta try, I suppose. Hell, if you get lucky, you get lucky. Okay. 32, 48, 48, obviously. God, that armor is hectic. 22, 28, 42. 3. Let's focus down this one. 70%, sweet, take that one. Oh, we're getting a few good hits in here. Doha, you are horribly outnumbered, so actually, shield wall and riposte is the way to go, but it's 37% shots. I'd rather just take the slash, you don't have the fatigue, because I mean, using riposte is 25, and that's 20. Exhausted too soon, which I don't want. This is bad, I can see us losing a couple guys here. Ouchie, ouchie. Hey, look at that. If everyone up front had flails, this would be such a different story. Please tell me you have a file. No, you don't. Oh, sent. Yeah, Joho, 1, 2, 3, 4. You're surrounded by 4 of these guys. Doesn't look good, mate. Yeah, it's 37. See how amazing the flails are against these things. I'm confident we can win, but my god, we're going to take a couple losses here. Come on, Randolph, hit one of these shots. Oh my word. 23, 28. Nice, that hit, awesome. I think it was this one's shield that I almost broke. 15, 34, 8. The hit chances are so damn low. Actually, it's Mainrad who's in the most trouble. 20%, 8%, 28. I'll just wait to see if one of them attacks twice in a turn. 30, 30, wait. 18%, 18, my word. I hate these things. 54, but it's undamaged. I rather want to try and focus one of these things down for 44. I think this 52 is the way to go. Tough. Almost, come on. I thought I had more flails than just these two. I could have sworn we had like 3 of these reinforced flails. I must have stupidly sold them. 40%, 35, 35. A couple of these are going to go down. Come on! Oh, 1 out of 4 flail shots hit. Fuck's sake. Well, Bosco, if they do, then it doesn't make any difference. It doesn't leave me in a different spot. And they don't always use shield wall. I mean, for example, one of these ones here attack twice in the turn. They do sometimes attack twice, and if they attack twice in the turn, it's just as good as having... the point is in they haven't used shield wall. 28, 8. Okay, 1 down, 10 to go. Oh, for fuck's sakes. Mainrad's fleeing. Might as well release the dog. Yeah, it's rare, but the percentage isn't 0, so it's worth trying. 23. I mean, like, here's a bit different because even though he's got shield wall, he's low enough health that if the 20% hits, it'll die. Then it doesn't get to take its shots. So then it's worth not waiting. But I mean, I waited on these ones because they weren't low enough. 47, 70. I guess the legionaries are a lot easier to hit. God, one of these hits and Joho's toast. The main rat was one of the guys we wanted to replace, but what's very disappointing is that we might have lost that axe. And it looks like the axe is lost. It's disastrous. Should have just run away. Oh, poor dog. Bastards. Oh, jeez, I could use punch. Interesting. 39%, 42%. Oh, one more hit. God damn it. Actually, don't mind that, because then Super Duper's in contact with those two with his flail. But thank you. Stupid zombies. Yeah, Joe has toast. He doesn't have enough fatigue to get his shield wall up. Becomes a slog now. 45, 47, 52. Nice. Joho! God, I hope he gets out of this alive. Fraggle. I actually would put Fraggle there, but I need to wait for Battle Brother to get murdered first. 31, 35. Ouchie. Our dog's still alive. Bless him. Oh! Actually, could do with a raise the morale here, because we've got a wavering and a lagging guy, and that's affecting their melee skill. Nice. I think the devs have confirmed that it's not going to be multiplayer ever. They want to focus on keeping the single player experience as tight as possible. I think it's really great. Oh, it didn't even work, for fuck's sake. God, Joe! He's tenacious, he's sticking in there. Oh, Randolph fleeing. Coward! Oh, Battle Brother, rip! You bastards! Oh! Come on, Loki. I need these flail guys to hit their fucking shots. Everyone's exhausted now is the problem. Woo. This is a tough situation. As soon as this guy goes down, it gets a lot easier. Ooh, doesn't look good for Joe. He, again, the fucking raise rally troops doesn't work. Could have been stabbing there. Seems like it's not worth killed Joho. Rip Joho. Damn it, we lost the Highlander. And one of the cripples. The loss of the cripple isn't a big problem at all, but the loss of that Highlander freaking sucks. Oh, these things are a nightmare to fight against. It's only the guys who've got flails who have hit them even remotely reliably. Things need balancing. I don't know. I don't think so. Probably just butt hurt. Finally, raise morale works. What do I do if the leader of the merc group dies? Like leader of our group, you mean? You just. It doesn't really. Just replace him with a different soldier. It's Stobbie is the one sergeant, but I've got another one ready to replace him. Oh god, Warmonger Loki hit just about nothing. 47. Yes! Once you finally able to hit these things, they go down quite quick, but just being able to hit them is the difficult part. You either need flails or a huge amount of axes to just go straight through their shields, but I've had more success with flails to go around the shields than axes to go through them, because they have shield experts, so the shields take twice as long as normal shields would to destroy. Oh my god, Loki can't hit a damn shot. It's so frustrating. There we go, finally one gets through. Another one. The thing is, this isn't fun. This is just a long, miserable slog. Oh my word. Struck down Oh, that's fine. Randolph sucked anyway. Randolph can get fucked. He was a terrible soldier. Randolph was one of the new guys, and he's no good. At this rate, I'm going to fire Loki. I can't remember the last time he actually hit a shot against him. But I think it's because he's breaking. He's got minus 20 melee skill. Come on, one more shot, lads. There we go. What did he get? Partly collapsed lung, yeah. Gonna retire him. Mainrad and Joho. Rip. We fought valiantly, men. That was a hell of a tough one. Nice reward, though. 980 gold. Couple of ancient swords, but we don't really need them. And we didn't lose the two-handed axe, is the main thing. Battle over. The forefather's standard obtained. Elements prepared for a return to Thorismund the Elder. You're not entirely sure who or what just attacked you, but right now it's time to get paid.